Good evening. You're on the News Hour at 10 this Friday evening. I'm Anand Narasimhan. First up, a quick check on the big stories that we are tracking on the News Hour tonight. The first and the biggest story comes from the valley. The murder of Shujaat Bukhari. The police confirming that Shujaat Bukhari's death was a terror act. But the lobby speaks for Pakistan. Netas playing politics even at Shujaat's funeral. They won't condemn terrorists. Rather, they will take that time out to attack the RSS and the Prime Minister on the grim situation in Kashmir and point fingers within their own rather than to the enemy across. Big story number two is Akbar versus Pratap. The Prime Minister has called for Sabka Saath, and this seems to be a trend. If it was Tejaswi Surya yesterday, you now have Yogi Adityanath today. His mantris, his leaders, very clearly wanting to unite Hindus against the Muslim combine. Today, Yogi Adityanath pitches Maharana Pratap ahead of the Mughal Emperor Akbar. But in that discourse on an RSS platform, he also says that all those people who fought with Maharana Pratap, that is Vanvasis, Dalits, etc., should consider themselves descendants of Maharana Pratap. That's where the twist comes. Communalizing history, polarizing history for your own ends. That's debate number two. And the big story number three, Delhi drama. The Dharna drama escalates. Four ambulances rush to the LG's residence. Governance takes a backseat for the fifth day in a row as Kejriwal and co. are busy cooling their heels off at the LG's residence. It is imperative to cool down tempers in and on Kashmir. This was Shujaat Bukhari's final pitch for peace. The noted journalist was shot dead for believing in peace, for preaching dialogue. Shujaat Bukhari was leaving his office when the killers fired multiple bullets at him. It was a premeditated attack, a planned assassination as per the police. It was a terror act. Hundreds of mourners coming together to pay their tributes at his ancestral village in Baramulla. And barely had Shujaat Bukhari's funeral taken place, a video emerged in which a bearded man is surveying the inside of the journalist's vehicle. He was then later on called suspect number four because even in the presence of cops, this man is seen pulling out Shujaat Bukhari's guard, picking up his pistol. We'll just go across to those visuals. These are the visuals that came in of the three stills of the three assailants, the three people who shot Shujaat Bukhari. Yeah, this is the visual, and we're picking up the pistol and disappearing from the scene. This is the entire sequence as it plays out. This man is the fourth suspect, besides the three men on the motorcycle who carried out the attack. He is the only suspect whose face is clearly visible because the driver of the motorcycle is seen wearing a helmet. The man sitting behind him is leaning on the other side, hiding his face, and then the second pillion, used a face mask to try and conceal his identity. Now, this white man has been arrested. He's clearly seen walking away with that pistol in his pocket. It was a 9mm that belonged to one of the PSOs who was actually gunned down by these terrorists. But many believe, and even the cops believe, that he has some connection. He was either the B team, the backup guy, or the OGW. This is what the agencies actually believe about this person. The agencies believe that there were two teams, Terror Team 1 and Terror Team 2. Three terrorists were on the bike. The fourth terrorist was the suspect on camera. If we can move forward, then the next aspect that they believe is that he was armed and masked. He was present near Bukhari's car. This was the person. Then they opened fire and fled. This man picking up the pistol and perhaps sticking around there so that he does not be seen running away from a scene of crime or scene of offense and be nabbed up by the people there because the cops were around. Now, this is what the so-called lobby said. They pushed that narrative which the Pakistan embassy was pushing from last night. But before we go across to that, there was a big breakthrough that happened. Now, the breakthrough that happened was that the fourth suspect caught on cam is in custody. They have also been able to perhaps nail two or three of the people. The pistol has been recovered. It has been sent for forensic examination. Then the breakthrough three that they have is that based on the evidence, the murder has been confirmed as a terror attack by the cops. And they also believe that they will be very soon be able to not just nail the identity of the three killers, but also perhaps nab them. But amidst all of this, there was a narrative that was being pushed from Pakistan. It started from the Foreign Office of Pakistan, then moved on to the United Jihad Council and the Lashkar. And then here, those voices that bat for Pakistan, or perhaps the proxies. A day after that, after Shujaat Bukhari was brutally shot dead by terrorists in Srinagar, the unthinkable happened. Now, this is what one of the so-called activists, who's also a JNU scholar, former JNU student, Shaila Rashid, who was present at the Congress's iftar party, and she's there at all these platforms, said, everyone at the funeral wonders why anyone would kill him. So everyone at the funeral was talking to only Shaila Rashid. They believe that this is the job of agencies, asking why there was no police CRPF there. So she totally forgot about the two PSOs who were also gunned, who were also shot at, who were present in the same car as Shujaat Bukhari. Forgot about it. Why would anyone want him dead except government, which seems to have reached a conclusion? This is what she has said. She forgets how Naveed Bhatt ran away from the Srinagar hospital. There was a grenade attack there. There were cops all around. Forget all that. Now, this is what Saifuddin Source says. If you bring more forces, voices of Kashmir will be muffled but not silenced. Then he goes on to further add. The suffocation that Modi has created through RSS, that should come to an end. If you can just continue that, please. Then our voice has been taken away. Warrior who was fighting the battle has been silenced. This is what Saifuddin Source says. Let's just get into the debate tonight. Saber Sniping with Zafar Islam and Vishwesh Rao.
You're watching the News Hour at 10. Debate number one on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
Why are these voices speaking in this tone? Zafar Islam. The state did it. The state killed Shujaat Bukhari because they were upset with the UNHCR report. State nahi marega to aur kaun marega usse? That's the kind of talk.
See, Anand, you have people like Shaila Rashid who are known anti-national. You have within the country people who are holding Indian passport but have loyalty with Pakistan and many other countries but not with his own motherland. You have people living in Kashmir, but they are the stooge of Pakistan. They are the people who work for Pakistan, but they do not work for the interest of their own nation. So we are battling with this problem, Anand, and that's why the terrorism, which has been somehow supported by and fully all the logistical support given by Pakistan, the rogue country, and we are tackling this problem. If you see last 4 years, number of terrorists have been killed by us. More than 700 terrorists have been gunned down by us in last 4 years. And secondly, these kind of attempts by terrorist forces, a terrorist against forces, is something and civilians and journalists like Shujaat Bukhari will not go unpunished, and we will unleash against these people for sure. And you will see after the Ramzan, just wait and watch, something will definitely happen to these people, because government of India will have a decisive action against these terrorists and people who are terrorizing the country.
Now let Mr. Vishwesh Rao speak. Mr. Vishwesh Rao, Mr. Vishwesh Rao. Now these are the people who come out and say that when we talk about the Maoist plot to kill the Prime Minister, they come out and point fingers at Mr. Nitin Gadkari and other people. Then when it comes out to that a journalist has been shot dead in broad daylight, they'll once again point fingers at our own rather than point fingers at the enemy, who's orchestrating this because they want the peace process to be derailed.
At a point,
what do you do about such people?
At a point of time when a leading journalist has been... At a point of time, when a leading journalist has been killed, I expect certainly, the BJP spokesperson to have a saner voice. But if you look at,
You expect only the BJP spokesperson to have a saner voice. So what the likes of Saifuddin Soz and some of the others have said, that is not insane. That is perfectly logical.
Yeah. No, well, I'm only talking about, you know, what Bukhari stood for. Bukhari stood for a moderate voice, a saner voice. Let us not be very rhetoric about it. Let us talk about, you know, the reality. Reality is, I'm simply asking a question, Mr. Vishwendra Rao. The government policy that
is your loyalty roads. With the country, or is your loyalty with the terrorists? Or terrorist organization? My simple question to you, Mr. Vishwendra Rao.
Are you loyal to your country?
Are you loyal to people who support their nation, who are dying for their nation? Or are you loyal to people who are actually against the interests of the nation?
No, no. I'm a professor. I'm an academic. I'm looking at, you know, the problem academically, analytically. The problem in Jammu and Kashmir is a political problem. I'm not saying. Bukhari also said.
So what does your analysis say? If you analyze the situation,
it's a political problem.
If you are seeing everything analytically, what does your analysis say in the last 4 years? We have provided everything possible to the people who are pro-Indian. We have only taken action against Vishwendra Rao, please hear me out.
Where is the development? Please hear me out. How convenient. Why don't you ask how many questions do you have to ask those people who come back with Pakistani dollars and pass it on to the pelters there to throw stones at our forces? How many questions have you asked of them, sir?
Sir Anand, you need to understand who is benefiting from the conflict. You tell me, sir, you are an intelligent gentleman, you say you are a teacher, you are an academic, you're senior to me, sir.
Let me ask you this. Please tell me what do you make of this? Please tell me, sir, what do you make of this? Zafar Islam, 1 minute. Sir, 22 hours ago, This is what the Pak foreign media says. Hear me out, sir. Professor, please hear me out.
What about the special state of
Please
there?
Hear me out.
What about the army?
Please hear me out, sir. Please hear me out. Please hear me out. You tell me what is the inference that you would draw. What is the inference? Sir, what is the inference that your own intelligent mind would draw, sir?
This should not be in operation.
Now hear me out, sir. What is the inference your own intelligent mind will draw? Hear me out. Kashmiri journalist Shujaat Bukhari's targeted killing within hours of his tweet on OHCHR report on Jammu and Kashmir. Terrible coincidence raises serious questions. India should investigate and ensure perpetrators are brought to justice. This is the Pak Foreign Office. Then. Now hear me. Hear me out.
Yeah.
United Jihad Council Chairman Syed Salahuddin blames Indian security forces for Bukhari's murder following the release of the UN report on Kashmir and demands an independent probe. Killing of Shujaat Bukhari at a time when UN Human Rights Commission released a report on human rights abuses by Indian forces raises many questions. LET, Lashkar-e-Toyba, calls Bukhari's murder a handiwork of the Indian security agencies. Separatists in Jammu and Kashmir say we need to investigate who has done it, are the forces involved. Shaila Rashid says, this is what the people at the funeral are talking. People at the funeral are talking that the forces have done it or the government has done it. Saifuddin Soz points at the atmosphere so-called because of Modi and his RSS leanings. You tell me, Vishwendra Rao, which narrative is being followed and by whom and why?
I am not talking about, you know, narrative of RSS. I am talking about, you know, the politics of conflict which is going on.
Look at this, gentleman.
Which is very, very important. After all that I said,
after all that I drew, Zafar Islam, what Professor Vishwendra Rao heard was only RSS. This is the obsession, sir. This is the obsession. ये आइडियोलॉजी के झगड़े में ये इंडिया का बैंड बजा रहे हैं।
आनंद,
that's what they're doing.
They have compromised, they have compromised in the country. For us as Indians to pose a united front against an enemy that is wanting to bleed us with a thousand cards, and you are swinging to their narrative. How bizarre is this?
I'm only posing two questions.
Zafar Islam.
The BJP spokesperson will have to admit, in the policy of Jammu and Kashmir, is a crossroads or not Anand, today. That
people like Visheshwar Rao.
Even politics are government going
on. People like Visheshwar Rao will only use their mind and analyze properly when it suits them. When it does not suit their narrative, they will make this kind of allegation. I'm very sad that a professor like him has no interest in safeguarding the nation. But he has full interest in siding with all the terrorist organizations and people who are supporting terrorism and supporting terrorists. How can you support a statement made by likes of Shaila Rashid, who are known anti-national, she doesn't want peace. What she wants that the nation should be divided into separate country. And she wants to support a country like Pakistan. She wants to speak their language. She wants to work at their behest. And would you like to support her? Would you support like people like her?
No, negotiate with who?
Kashmir,
negotiate with who? You tell
Kashmir,
me, Visheshwar Rao, can we put out that visual? I just want him to hear. I just want him to see these visuals. Can we put out the banihal? What our soldiers, the amount of restraint our soldiers exercise today? You see these visuals. You see these visuals, Professor Visheshwar Rao. And you tell me, had you been inside that bus, what would you have done? Had you been inside this bus, what would you have done? Can we put those visuals out, please?
Will you negotiate with someone who is pelting you with stones?
Will you sit there and negotiate? Come pelt stones at me because I am here to negotiate with you. Come pelt stones with me because I am here to hear this and look at this. Visheshwar Rao, you look at this and you tell me if this is not restraint, if this is not the fact that our intent is for peace, then what else is? What stopped these CRPF policemen? Listen to the stones. Now tell me, Visheshwar Rao, what were our soldiers doing?
Yeah.
Why is it the UN Human Rights Council doesn't see this? Doesn't anybody in Kashmir see this? Why don't those people who are batting for the other side see this? How much of restraint would you have shown?
United Nations Human Rights.
How much of restraint would you have shown?
For a long time, they were talking that from their perspective, human rights violations. Does anyone say there are no human rights violations in Kashmir?
So these people
say that there are no human rights violations.
What is this according to you? Is this not a violation of the human right of that CBR, of those CRPF jawans inside that bus?
You
tell me, is this or is this not the human right violation of those CRPF jawans? You tell me, sir. You tell me, sir. Is this or is this not? Is this or is this not? Did you see those visuals? Were their human rights being violated or not? Do you have concern for them? Do you have concern for them?
Were their human rights violated or not?
Do you have concern for them? Despite all this, we are saying extend the ceasefire. Despite all this, we are saying let's work towards peace. Despite all this, this government is saying we will not pick up the gun first. We will not seek out and kill you. And you are saying this government is not showing intent? Start calling out the rogues. Start calling out those people who don't have no
contradictions in government policy.
All right, you start. Why you tell me? Three things you want to tell Pakistan today. You tell me three things you want to tell Pakistan today. Tell me three things you want to tell the Hurriyat today. Tell me three things you want to tell the Hurriyat today. Tell me three things you want to tell Zakir Musa today. Tell me three things you want to tell Pakistan and Afisai today. Let's start there first. Sermonizing and lecturing because you have a political ideological rival in the government. That's all you will do, sir. Talk about the enemies of your country first. Give them a sermon now. I give you 2.5 minutes. Can you give them a sermon? Can you give them a lesson?
The policy after, you know, after 1 year.
Don't talk about the policy of this country. Talk about the policy of the Hurriyat. Talk about the policy. Talk about the policy of Pakistan. Talk about what you say, what you want to say to Hafiz Saeed. Tell me what you want to be done.
Yes. But then it's also important to know, we are not even trying to understand the problem. If you don't understand the problem,
tell me what you want to tell
problem,
them.
It's a political problem.
Tell me
how
what you want to tell them.
If you say it's a problem,
tell the people watching the news are what you want to tell them.
I'm going to find a solution.
Tell the people watching the news are what you want to tell them.
Who has analytical mind?
Why has the cat got your tongue down?
Loves to analyze the situation.
Why has the cat got your tongue now? Why has the cat got your tongue now? You get all your verbal diarrhea abusing the Prime Minister, this government and our forces. But the cat gets your tongue the moment I ask you to say 4 words about the Hurriyat, about Hafiz Saeed and about Pakistan. Why, sir?
I'm only saying Jammu and Kashmir is not a land order problem. It's a political issue.
Yeah.
Human rights violations are taking place.
Now, Professor Visveshwar Rao also parroting the tone, that narrative that's come from the other side, sir. These people want to establish the rule of the Sharia. They are doing it in the name of Allah. They want to establish the rule of Ummah. They want, and that escapes you, sir. That escapes your wisdom, your vision, your periphery, and your intelligence. Fantastic, sir. Fantastic. Not one word. Not one word you have said against Hafiz Saeed. Not one word you have said against Pakistan. Not one word you have said against the Hurriyat.
Anand. The editor was killed and was stood for objectivity.
Why has the cat got your tongue, sir?
You are a leading journalist.
Why has the cat got your tongue, sir? Why has the cat got your tongue, sir? Why has the cat got your tongue, sir? Why has the cat got your tongue, sir?
Let him understand the reality of Kashmir problem.
Yeah. How many times have you gone there to see the reality? I see the reality with these jawans. I see the reality with the restraint they are showing. I see the reality that they don't pick up the gun, but they actually bow down because they say, let them vent it out, because we have the ability, we have the heart, and we have the love to bear it. That's what they are showing. You don't see that. How come you are blind to that, sir?
See, no. Journalism is all about truth.
Journalism
is all about objectivity.
Sir,
why
don't you speak the truth tonight? Why don't you for a change speak the truth tonight? Why don't you for a change speak the truth tonight, sir? Why don't you for a change speak the truth tonight? Why don't you for a change speak the truth tonight? Or sir, are you so blinded by your ideological rivalry with the government at the center that the truth also escapes you today?
Anand.
I have to move on for the moment here on the News Hour.
No,
I have to move on here on the News Hour. But this is what Times Now would like to ask as we wind up the big story and this debate on the lobby speaks for Pakistan. When all the proof collected so far points towards the involvement of pro-Pak terrorists, then how are peaceniks blaming the RSS and the Prime Minister? Is the dialogue lobby playing into Pakistan's hand by blaming the Prime Minister and the RSS for murder while giving a clean chit to terrorists? And does politics compel the lobby to exempt radicals from reciprocating to the ceasefire?